You always wanted to paint. To create a masterpiece. You have talent but have not started creating. In this short video you will learn the materials and colors to get started on your painting journey. Learn the basics you will need to know to set up your starter kit and keep costs down. So let's get started.
Welcome to the Sunday Painter. Please click and subscribe. Hit the like button and don't forget the little bell so you will be the first when we have an inspirational idea. Leave a happy creative comment.
Here is a basic palette. These are the colors used in the artwork shown at the beginning of the video. Over time you will delete some of these colors because you will be able to mix any color you want just from primary and secondary colors. Which we will talk about in an upcoming video. The colors are laid out into a workable palette. Just follow the color chart. Let's talk about brushes. You can buy a starter kit like this. It's synthetic hairs with flat, round and filberts. All you will need to start painting. I've had students that only bought expensive brushes, but when I take a simple cheap brush and outpaint them they are amazed. I tell them that the talent is in the artist not the brush. I still use this kit today. You can find it at Hobby Lobby or Amazon which all the materials coming up in the video are from. Liquin is a medium with a dryer. Mediums help make the oil paint flow better and also thins the oil paint. They make all types of medium oils, but I paint with thin colors or glazes like the old masters. Using walnut or any other type of medium may take days to dry for the next layer. Using liquin, you can do an underpainting and the next day the oil is dry enough to paint in the details. Liquin comes in different thicknesses but liquin original is the overall best. Next you will need odorless turpentine to clean your brushes. A little goes a long way. Don't use turpentine to thin your oils. Next you will need to have a jar with a coil so when you clean your brushes the excess paint will fall to the bottom and not on your brushes. Next you will need an easel. This tabletop will hold up to a 16 by 20 canvas which is standard. It's easy to carry and set up. If you do larger paintings as you get better a floor easel will be needed. I find this tabletop will work with the majority of your paintings. I have several because they are cheap and very sturdy not only to paint on but display your artwork too. Now you will need a canvas. I have students that buy the very best canvases. You will not need this. They sell pre-made canvases in packs of 2 or 5 which are the best price. There are different brands, but you will have to buy them as you need them to figure out which one works the best for you. I use all types. Before starting to use a pack canvas take 120 to 220 sandpaper to smooth out the gesso. Some are rougher than others. Canvas size that works best are 11 by 14 and 16 by 20. These are standard sizes plus they make a lot of cheap frames that fit these canvases. Now you will need a paper palette. These are nice because when you are done you throw them away. If you put more paint than you used you can put plastic wrap over the paint and put them in the fridge to keep them from drying out if you paint every few days. Now to the oil paint colors. You don't need big tubes to start out. I find these oil paint kits work well for starting out. A little goes a long way and you can add colors as you paint. One last word, to be good at anything takes time and practice. So today I want you to start your 1-year journey to becoming a painter. Put on the calendar and become consistent with your practice. I found when the 1 year is up you have painted works people want. Also you won't have that regret that you wished you started a year ago. Just have fun it will come.